Hello, everybody. It's great to have you in this session today. My name is Prakash Ayer. I'm a client partner at Cognizant, and I'm part of the Dutch leadership team. I'm very happy to have Jeorn Kruscha from Bayer today with us. And today in this conversation, we are going to discuss data modernization program at Bayer together with Google Cloud Platform and Cognizant. It's great to have you, Jeorn, today. Thank you so much for your time.
Hi, Prakash. Great to be with you today. My name is Jeorn Kruscha. I'm the Crop Science EMEA Data Lead. So EMEA is Europe, Middle East, and Africa. And I'm very fond of doing things on data, and that's what we did together with Cognizant since last year.
Let's get started, Jeorn. What is Bayer's unique approach to staying ahead of competition?
At Bayer, we have got a vision that is driving us, and that's health for all and hunger for none. And at the Crop Science Division, we are working for farmers, helping them to produce high quality crops. We engage in different markets, like huge farms, big like counties, down to smallholders. It's about the whole package. We've got high quality products, we've got high quality services, and we want to generate high yields and high quality crops. This is where digital kicks in and where data can help. And we are continuing to evolve on this journey.
Thank you so much, Jeorn, for sharing your insights. Now, what is Bayer's vision for creating a data-driven business? And how do you set about achieving that vision?
At Bayer, we strive to be the digital-enabled leader in agriculture business. Digital drives innovation, improved decision-making, improved customer experience, improved employee experience. To us, digital-enabled means data-driven. And as for any modern company, data serves as a foundation for it. We already generate an abundance of data, and how it links together and how we can generate more value out of it is something that is of utmost importance for us. This is where the FAIR data principles come into the game. FAIR meaning findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable. I really doubt that we will see a day where all our data once resides in the single platform. Nevertheless, bringing a lot of data into a single platform helps to achieve all of those four principles. And that is what we did. Together with Cognizant, we created the EMEA Data Fair. We started onboarding data for four applications. We're using data sources like Salesforce, MS Dynamics, SAP ERP systems, files, homebrew application. We linked them all together in a single system. And now we are really exploring new purposes because a lot of people are interested in reusing the data. And that's what the great story is about.
If I could ask, why Google Cloud? What unique value did Google Cloud bring to the table for Bayer in this data modernization program?
Some years ago at Crop Science, we were looking for this new platform and we choose BigQuery. And why? Because there are built-in AI and ML functionalities. There are also geospatial functions that, of course, in agriculture business, we very much rely on. And there was also a lot of trust that the development is moving ahead in the right way. For my region, EMEA, it is also important that we can store the data wherever we want to. So we are creating a space on our own locally, literally stored within the EU, and everyone aware of GDPR knows of what importance that is. While we're benefiting from the efforts of a global team, we can set up our own space and by this suit our real regional demands and the flexibility from Google BigQuery in this area is key to us.
Thank you so much, Jeorn. I'm sure the audience, especially the data leaders, will be able to learn a lot from these insights. What specific business and the technology value did Cognizant bring to the table for Bayer in this program?
It's important that we not only are ahead of all the technologies, we also have to ensure that it meets our organizational demands. So sometimes I need a partner that is not always going for the super very best solution, but a solution that fits to the overall organization. And here Cognizant comes into the game. And looking at a company big like Bayer, this requires definitely experience and, even more important, patience. I want to share some statements from my team that were they gave about the Cognizant team members that were working with us. And they just quote, had a deep understanding of full stack encompassing their domain. Another statement is they quote, set priorities and adjust when unexpected situations arise. Or quote, they very quickly understand what we mean. And believe me, understanding what Bayer means is a tough business. And finally, quote, respond with clarity and honesty. That was important for us.
I really appreciate that, Jeorn. I think it's always great to hear some nice words and great words from the clients. Now, what would be your top three recommendations to a data leader who's embarking on a similar data journey like yours?
First of all, I would say value the data workers. They've got more knowledge than they are given credit for. Focus on the value they are creating first, rather than talking about technology and the quality of data they're using. Or let me just put it straight, don't smirk once you see that they're using Microsoft Excel as a centerpiece. Just show appreciation for their results. Second, balance between local tailoring, and this goes for this end user scheme, you know, make your end user happy, and the global strategy scheme, which is the single version of the truth. You have to manage the diversity. That's of utmost importance, and I'm still seeking out on this one. Maybe you should check ideas like inheritance and forking in this area. Most important, build on trust. Give unconditional trust at the very start to workers and partners. But this is true for each and every project anyway.
Once again, thank you so much for your insights. I'm sure a lot of data leaders will learn a lot and benefit a lot from this learnings. If I were to ask you to guess in a crystal ball, what do you think is the future of data and how it might impact the organization business strategies?
I think the usage and demand for data will still rise, and it's beyond this data science hype cycle that we're currently seeing. So first, watch out for the usage of data in rather easy modes or commonality, so paths that are not decision signs. I see there will be a lot of movement in there. And as well, when it comes to squeezing the knowledge out of the data, the question of how can we link data together and what can we learn out of it, I would assume becomes even more important, so that maybe a machine can search for links between maybe an IoT sensor sending data and customer retention. Finally, I still have hope that we will have an access, data access policy that is based on information. I doubt that we will see that within the last 4 years, but currently we're doing access management again and again and again on different technologies. Finally, access management only relies on the content. I would love to see that we solve this once and forever, because we're taking the content and not the technology into account. Why? I rate access management rather boring.
Thank you so much, Jeorn, for your time today. There are lots of insights and takeaways from this session. I'm sure our audience will learn a lot from this. Once again, thank you and wish you a nice day.